हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल. एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू?
यस
ओके, तो
सर।
वी विल कंटिन्यू विथ आवर यूनिट नंबर टू. यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड द यूनिट नंबर टू, दैट इज द इंट्रोडक्शन टू द कर्नल. यू कैन सी द स्लाइड्स ऑन योर स्क्रीन. ओके, सी, दीज आर द कंटेंट ऑफ यूनिट नंबर टू, आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. दैट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस यूनिट, वेयर द आर्टिकल कैन ऑल्सो बी नेम्ड एज इंट्रोडक्शन टू द आर आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द कर्नल. समटाइम्स इट कैन बी रीनेम्ड दैट ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ द कर्नल और ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ द सिस्टम कर्नल, बट इट इज वन एंड सेम दैट वेन एवर यू कैन सी द आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, इट कैन बी अ आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द कर्नल ऑल्सो. ओके, दिस थिंग यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस. ओके, सो दिस इज द आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. हियर यू कैन सी द टाइटल इज ऑल्सो गिवन एज द ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ द सिस्टम कर्नल. सो माई डियर स्टूडेंट, यू काइंडली कीप इन माइंड दैट वेन एवर द क्वेश्चन कम्स फॉर 8 मार्क्स, एंड इफ द क्वेश्चन इज लाइक दिस, आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द यूनिक्स सिस्टम, देन फॉर 8 मार्क्स यू हैव टू ड्रॉ दिस फिगर. वेन एवर द क्वेश्चन कम फॉर 4 मार्क्स, देन यू हैव टू ड्रॉ द फिगर दैट सर्कुलर आर्किटेक्चर, लेयर 0, लेयर 1, लेयर 2, लेयर 3. Is this thing clear to everybody? Is this thing is clear to everybody? No? Yes or no? Yes, very good. Okay. I know that this 4:30, 3:40 is the time where it's difficult to learn. Okay. Already you have attended many sessions throughout the day, right from 10 a.m. and this session of OSA is comes at last at 3:40. So still we have to bear with all these things, and you have to pay attention to this lecture because this is very important point as far as the syllabus is concerned. Architecture of the Unix operating system, you can see in the figure, like there is a user level, okay, there is a kernel level, and again many blocks are there. So what is these blocks? These blocks are basically, you can see there is a libraries. Okay, so libraries, that means a system function, the predefined libraries which comes here. With the help of this library, the user can write his or her own program. Like we normally follow the practice in C language or in Java also, in Python also, we use many library functions. Okay, so in shell script also we are using the library functions. So this library functions, actually this this is the function, and a big program is written beside that, behind that library function. We normally use that functions only, and we normally make a use of that big program. So instead of writing and remembering and understanding the whole program itself, we are just using the library functions in our program. So that is a important activity of this library. So these libraries are available in every language. Like in C language also there is a library files, library functions. In Java also we are including the library files. In Python also we are including the library files. In shell also we are using the library files. So that is the meaning of this. The user can make use of this library to write his or her own program. So this thing happens at user level. Now, whenever in the user program any system call encounter, kindly concentrate my sentence. What I am saying, whenever in the user program any system call is encounter. Okay, and this thing is equally applicable to the library functions. Whenever in the library functions any system call encounter, then what happens? Then there is a switch from user level to kernel level. Okay, so who will switch this? The operating system, the kernel, will switch from the now the the actual execution of the program will switch from user level to the kernel level. Is this thing is clear to everybody? It is clear to everybody? Yes. So now I will give you the example. Whenever the system call, suppose you are writing a program and a system call, like there is a system called fork. So whenever the fork system call is encountered, then the control goes to kernel level. Now in kernel level, you can see there is a first block is a system call interface itself. So there are a big list of the system call available in the Linux system. And below this, you can see there is a file subsystem. And on the right-hand side, you can see there is a process control subsystem. Now, all these system calls, my dear student, you kindly pay attention. All these system calls are divided into these two subsystems, like a file subsystem and process control subsystem. Okay. So then there are rest of the blocks. We will not talk about the rest of the block right now. Okay. But we will focus on the file subsystem. Last time also we started this file subsystem. So now what is meant by file system? So see here. This figure gives the block diagram of the kernel, showing the various modules and their relationship to each other. In particular, it shows the file subsystem on the left and process control subsystem on the right. These are the two major components of the kernel. So somebody can ask you that, what are the two major components of the kernel? So instantly or immediately you have to reply that the two very important components of the kernel is file subsystem and process control subsystem. Okay. Now you can see in the next line the diagram, the previous diagram, which serves as a useful logical view of the kernel. Although in practice, the kernel deviates from model because some module interact with the internal operations of others. Okay. Now there are three levels in the figure that is written here. First one is the user level, second one is the kernel level, and last one is the hardware level. Now this system call and the library interface represent the border between the user program and the kernel. Okay. So that you can easily understand what is meant by the border, because this system call and interface that actually comes at the border of the sorry of the Unix kernel. Then what is the system call? Many times I repeat that system call is like an ordinary C function, okay? And libraries that map these function calls to the primitives needed to enter the operating systems. Okay, so system calls like a fork is a system call. Now you're familiar with fork, no? So fork is a system call, and this is very similar to the ordinary C function, where the libraries are used to map these function calls to the primitives needed to enter the operating systems. Okay. So every system call is like ordinary C function, which is written in C language only. So C language is having a library function. So we know the library files are included. Now these library functions and the system calls is normally needed to enter into the operating system. So I hope that you will be able to understand all these things. Okay. Because until and unless you are not using the system call, actual entry in the operating system will not take place. Okay, so that is the meaning of this. Now, the next line you can read, the assembly language program may invoke system calls directly without system call library, however. So, that is the job of assembly language program. So, we are normally using the high level programming language, but assembly level programs that may invoke the system call directly without the system call library. See, in the next line you can read here, programs frequently use other libraries such as standard input-output library to provide a more sophisticated use of system calls. And libraries are linked with the other programs at compile time and are thus a part of user program for the purpose of discussion. Okay, this already we discussed yesterday, and this is the important point of this discussion, that a figure, that means the block diagram, is actually partitioning into the set of system calls, and this partition took place into the two parts that we called it as a subsystem. First one is the file subsystem, and second one is the process control subsystem. Okay. Now, what is the file subsystem? So the next line is very important. You can read it. The file subsystem manages the file. File subsystem manages the file. It's allocating the file space. It is administrating the free space. It is controlling the file access, and it's retrieving the data for the user. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the very important part of a file system. So I repeat that what file system can do, file system can manage the files. So anybody can reply, what do you mean by managing the file? Secondly, it is saying that the file system is normally allocating the file space. So what do you mean by allocating the file space? Then you can read there, file system is normally administrating the free space. So what do you mean by administrating the free space? Later on, you can read there, the file system is actually controlling the access to the files. And lastly, you can see the file system is normally used for retrieving the data for the user. So my dear student, this is actually the job of file system that is very important in a Linux operating system, not only in Linux, as we are talking about Linux, but this is equally applicable in other operating systems also. Got it? So I think that now managing the file means, see here, how to manage the file. The question is that how to manage the file. So managing the file, that means whenever we create the file, so it is one type of operation, create a file. Whenever we are saying that we are opening the file, so that is the one type of operation. Whenever I am saying that I am reading the file, I am writing the file, I am executing the file, I am closing the file, I am modifying the file, I am changing the access right of the file, that means I am doing something. So all these things are nothing but the activities that whatever the responsibility of the file system is, that is actually executed by all these operations. So that's why you can read in the next line that processes interact with the file system via a specific set of system calls. Okay, now a system call is a very essential entity. I can say it is an entity, or basically it is a library functions like ordinary C function. Okay, this is very important part in Linux operating system. This plays a very important part in Linux operating system. System call, you kindly keep in mind. Now you can read there, whenever the process interact with the file systems. Now what is the process? What is the process? What is the process? Process is the instance of program which is in execution. Yes or no? So whenever a process is interacting with the file system, and how it can interact? It interact with the specific set of the system call. My dear student, you kindly keep in mind, this is a specific set of the system call. Specific set of system calls. So how many system calls are there? There are many system calls, but here it is listed that, like it is a open. So open is a system call. So what is the job of open? You can read there, it is used to open a file for reading or writing purpose. Okay, so we are opening the file. We can open the file by using open system call. Like the later on you can read, there is a close system call, then there is a read system call, write system call, stat. Stat normally stand for a statistic, and it is a query the attributes of the file. Then there is a chown, that is change the record of the owner who owned the files. Then there is a chmod that now in the practical I am explaining to batches that what is meant by chmod, which is actually change the access permission of the file. So these are the how many are there? You can count like one open is first, close, सेकंड, थ्री, फोर, फाइव, सिक्स, सेवन. सो दिस सेवन सिस्टम कॉल्स आर देयर. दीज आर नॉर्मली रिलेटेड टू द फाइल्स ऑफ सिस्टम. ओके, सो नाउ एनीबडी कैन आस्क यू दैट व्हाट आर द सिस्टम कॉल्स व्हिच आर नॉर्मली रिलेटेड टू द फाइल सिस्टम. सो हाउ व्हाट आंसर यू कैन गिव टू देम. ओके, व्हाट आर द सिस्टम कॉल्स व्हिच आर नॉर्मली रिलेटेड टू द फाइल सिस्टम्स. ओके, सो इन इन सेमेस्टर एग्जामिनेशन श्योरली देयर विल बी अ क्वेश्चन दैट what are the system calls which are normally related to the files of systems. So what will be your answer? What will be your answer? Anybody can unmute the mic and tell me the system calls which are normally related with the files of systems. Yes, anybody? Nobody want to speak. Open, close, read, write. That ph mode, ph mode. Absolutely right. That whatever the system calls written by here in chat box, Shraddha has written it. That open, close, read, write also. Write also. Here you can see reading and writing. That means write is the system call. Then stat, ch1 and chmod. All these are the system calls which are normally related to the files of system. We are going to learn all the system calls one by one. Okay. So here, now you can read the next line. The files of system access the file data using buffering mechanism that regulates the data flow between kernel and secondary storage device. A very interesting point. The files of system access the file data using a buffering mechanism. To understand the buffering mechanism, I must move the slide back to this figure. So here is the buffering mechanism. And what the statement we are using, we are saying that file systems, read the statement, file subsystem access the file data. File subsystem access the file data using buffering mechanism. So what is mean by buffering? Can anybody explain what is mean by buffering mechanism? That actually regulates the data flow between the kernel and the secondary storage device. So here is the buffer. You can see the buffer cache is there. The file system can access the file data by using buffering mechanism. That is actually the mechanism present between the kernel and the, what they said, secondary storage device. So you can read the line once again. The file subsystem access the file data using buffering mechanism that regulates the data flow between kernel and secondary storage device. So I will move back. What is the meaning of buffering mechanism? Can anybody know what is mean by buffer? What is the buffer? What is the buffer? What is the buffering mechanism? Here, dear student, buffering means it is a temporary storage. Buffer is like it's a memory which is used for temporary storage. Kindly concentrate on my sentence. It is used for temporary storage. Now we are saying that the file subsystem access the file data by using buffering mechanism, which actually regulates the data flow between kernel and secondary storage device. ये sentence आपके slide में मैंने पढ़ा था. Okay. तो क्या होता है कि एक्चुअली द फाइल इज लोकेटेड, वेयर द फाइल इज लोकेटेड, कैन एनीबडी टेल मी वेयर द फाइल लोकेटेड? फाइल इज लोकेटेड ऑन द सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज डिवाइस माय डियर स्टूडेंट. सी आई इनिशियली आई मेक इट क्लियर दैट इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू लर्न. It's very difficult to learn and understand the thing at 4:30 or 4 o'clock, okay, in the afternoon, where earlier you attended many lectures and practicals. But still, now we have to bear with all these things, and you have to be concentrate and listen to me carefully. What I am saying, where the file is located. File is located on the secondary storage device. Okay, Siddhant is saying absolutely right, secondary memory. So secondary memory means it is a hard disk where the file is located. Now we want to open a file. We means what? A process want to interact with file. Process want to interact with file. Hum program run karte. Program, process is nothing but the program in execution. So whenever the program is in execution, process want to interact with the file. So process want to open the file. Yes or no? So now the file is available on the secondary memory, as Siddhant also said. That file is available on the secondary memory. Secondary memory is a secondary storage device, that is a hard disk. So in the offline class, in the classroom, I explained to you that how the secondary memory is organized, how the secondary memory is organized. Secondary memory is organized in terms of blocks. Okay, so that's why you can see here the blocks are divided. Blocks are shown, no? Blocks. Okay, every block is of size 128 KB. Primary memory is organized in terms of pages. Each page is of 64 KB. ये मैंने क्लासरूम में पढ़ाया था और वहां पे कहा था कि अरे सडनली somebody अनम्यूट. तो लिसन, सेकेंडरी मेमोरी इज नॉर्मली ऑर्गेनाइज इन टर्म्स ऑफ ब्लॉक and each block is having a block number, like block 0, block 1, block 2, block 3, block 4, and each block is of a particular size. It is of 128 KB. So that's why you can see in the figure, see the figure clearly, where I pointed the mouse pointer on this block. What is this block? Where actually the file is available. Now, whenever the file system wants to interact with the file, that means मुझे file open करनी है. So that means the buffering mechanism take place. Buffering mechanism means a temporary the file is available in the buffer cache, where the file system can access the buffer. If the file is available there, then it is well and good. Otherwise, it is accessing the block, that is secondary memory. So in other way, I can say that frequently used files are stored in the buffer cache, where file system can access the buffer cache. If the required file is found there, then it will be accessed. Otherwise, the file system can access the block device. This is the meaning of this buffering. Okay. So I can move to this slide where you can read the statement. The file subsystem access the file data using the buffering mechanism that regulates the data flow between the kernel and the secondary storage device. Next, the device driver are the kernel modules that control the operator of peripheral device. Operations, it control the operations. Yeah, operator ho gaya yahan pe. This actually control the operations of the peripheral device. The peripheral devices, now you can see in the figure. So like it is connected to the hardware, where peripheral devices like printer, scanner, pen drive, terminal, monitor, screen, a network device, network card, any other computer, display, whatever may be the peripheral devices that can be controlled by this device driver. ओके, तो इतना पार्ट तो हो गया। देन नेक्स्ट, क्लियर। क्लॉक इनपुट आउटपुट डिवाइसेस आर रैंडम एक्सेस स्टोरेज डिवाइस, अल्टरनेटिवली देयर डिवाइस ड्राइवर मेक देम अपीयर टू रैंडम एक्सेस स्टोरेज डिवाइस टू द रेस्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम। ओके, ब्लॉक इनपुट आउटपुट लाइक इनपुट डिवाइस एंड आउटपुट डिवाइस। तो मैं हमेशा कहता हूँ कि पेन ड्राइव इज द इनपुट डिवाइस, यस और नो? वेयर इट इज अ ब्लॉक डिवाइस, एक्चुअली इट इज अ ब्लॉक डिवाइस। प्रिंटर इज द आउटपुट डिवाइस, इट इज अ ब्लॉक डिवाइस। ओके, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, प्रिंटर इज ऑल्सो द आउटपुट डिवाइस, इट इज अ ब्लॉक डिवाइस। पेन ड्राइव इज द इनपुट डिवाइस, इट इज अ ब्लॉक डिवाइस। विच आर रैंडम एक्सेस स्टोरेज डिवाइस, ओके, देयर द डिवाइस ड्राइवर मेक देम अपीयर टू बी रैंडम एक्सेस स्टोरेज डिवाइस फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम। सो दिस पेन ड्राइव, दिस प्रिंटर, स्कैनर is actually appear as a random access storage device to the rest of the system. Okay, clear to everybody? Itna part aapko samajh mein aaya kya? Left hand side files of system dekha humne, buffer dekha, then a character device driver and block device driver. Actually device driver is the name of the block, and there are two types of device driver, that is the character device driver and the block device driver. So block device driver, like I said, that is the input device pen drive. And character device driver, like there is the output device printer. So character device driver and block device driver. Okay, so they are the random access storage device for rest of the system. So where actually in a block device, it can be a hard disk also. Okay, the file is stored, and with the help of buffering mechanism, the files of system open the files, close the files, read the file, write the file, execute the file, check the state of the file, or change the mode of the file and perform many operation of the file. Okay, and then now you see the right hand side, process control subsystem. So here now the next paragraph, second paragraph, you can read what they are saying, that the process control subsystem is responsible for process synchronization, inter process communication, memory management and process scheduling. So again, if you see the block diagram, where you can see the process control subsystem is actually having three sub blocks. I can call it as a sub block. Somebody can say that these are the sub operations which can be performed by this process control subsystem. That is absolutely right. Okay. So process control subsystem is having three sub blocks. First one is inter process communication, IPC. Second one is scheduling, also called as scheduler, and third one is memory management. Okay, this you kindly keep in mind. The process control subsystem is responsible for process synchronization, inter-process communication. So what is mean by process synchronization and inter-process communication? What is the process synchronization and inter-process communication? What is mean by synchronization? Can anybody explain what is mean by synchronization? Synchronization. Nobody knows what is meant by synchronization. Synchronization means like, see, now I will give you the example. Like right now you are there, Chetan is saying that many things at a same time, many many things at same time. Okay, I will explain to you that what is meant by synchronization. Now this our Google Meet is going on, no? We are communicating with each other with the help of Google Meet. So actually you are a student, 35 students are there, and one teacher is here. Okay, so whatever I am explaining to you, you need to be synchronized with me. Samajh mein aaya aapko? You have to be synchronized with me. So matlab main aapko simple language mein batana chahta hu ki Siddhant is saying parallel execution. No, no, my dear student, it is not a parallel execution. Here मैं वही आपको एक्सप्लेन कर रहा हूँ, कि गूगल मीट चल रहा है, यहाँ पे एक टीचर है, मैं टीचर हूँ, आप 36 स्टूडेंट्स है, तो यू नीड टू सिंक्रोनाइज विथ मी। मेनी टू वन, व्हाट व्हाट यू आर एक्चुअली गिविंग द आंसर? आई एम नॉट गेटिंग। थ्री ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स हैव गिवन सिंक्रोनाइजेशन मेनी थिंग्स एट सेम टाइम, पैरेलल एग्जीक्यूशन, मेनी टू वन। आई डोंट नो व्हाट दे आर थिंकिंग, बट यू काइंडली लिसन टू मी, लिसन टू मी व्हाट आई एम सेइंग। सिंक्रोनाइज, सोम क्षीरसागर इज सेइंग दैट ऑपरेशन ऑफ टू और मोर थिंग्स एट द सेम टाइम। तो सुनो अभी, नाउ यू डोंट राइट एनीथिंग इन द चैट बॉक्स, काइंडली लिसन टू मी, व्हाट इज मीन बाय सिंक्रोनाइजेशन? यू नीड टू सिंक्रोनाइज विथ मी। यू आर अ प्रोसेस, आई एम अ प्रोसेस, व्हाट इज मीन बाय प्रोसेस? तो मैंने पढ़ाया आपको कि प्रोसेस इज अ प्रोग्राम विच इज इन एग्जीक्यूशन, जो कुछ एग्जीक्यूशन में है उसे प्रोसेस कहते हैं। तो हम बातें कर रहे हैं, मैं पढ़ा रहा हूँ, आप सुन रहे हैं, ओके, वी आर एक्चुअली इन एग्जीक्यूशन, तो वी आर अ प्रोसेस, वी बोथ आर अ प्रोसेस। डू यू एग्री विथ मी? तो आई एम वन प्रोसेस एंड यू आर अ अदर प्रोसेस एंड यू नीड टू कम्युनिकेट विथ मी, इंटर प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन। प्रोसेस नीड टू सिंक्रोनाइज विथ इच अदर। तो मैं पढ़ा रहा हूं आपको, तो आपको पढ़ना है, समथिंग इज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग हेयर, यू हैव टू लिसन इट, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इट। तो सम इनपुट इज आई एम गिविंग एंड यू हैव टू परफॉर्म सम थॉट प्रोसेस ओवर देयर टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट मोर क्लियरली। So then it will actually, I can say that the students are actually synchronizing with the staff. समझ में आ रहा है ना? तो इसके अपोजिट मैं आपको बताता हूं कि अगर मैं यहाँ पे पढ़ा रहा हूं और आप अगर वहां पे दूसरा कुछ काम कर रहे हैं, माइट बी इट पॉसिबल नो, सम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट ऑफ 37 स्टूडेंट्स आर हियर, सम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट they can perform any other task, now the mobile is going on, they can talk with their parents or they can talk with their friends and they are watching television also. So it might possible, I'm not saying that all students are doing this, but it might possible that you are doing some other activities over there. That means whatever I am teaching here, you are not synchronizing with me. Are you getting now what is mean by synchronizing? So same thing is required in the operating system, that every process need a synchronization with other process. So suppose again in easier manner I can explain, one process is executing a task, whatever the output is obtained after execution, because of that output other process can affect, so that is called as synchronization. So when it will take place, it will take place whenever the both processes are communicating with each other. Now you and me are communicated with each other via this Google Meet, yes or no? So that means we are having an inter-process communication with between us. Again, I can say that there are 37 process, 37 different students are there located at different places. आप भी एक जगह पे नहीं है, आप अलग अलग जगह पे बैठे हैं अभी। तो ऑल वी आर सिंक्रोनाइजिंग विद इच अदर, ऑल वी आर सिंक्रोनाइजिंग विद इच अदर, ऑल वी आर कम्युनिकेटिंग विद इच अदर, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोसेस सिंक्रोनाइजेशन। तो वही सब चीजें ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम में भी होती है कि एक प्रोसेस दूसरे प्रोसेस के साथ कम्युनिकेट करती है। वन प्रोसेस इज कम्युनिकेटिंग विद अदर प्रोसेस, अदर प्रोसेस इज कम्युनिकेटिंग विद थर्ड प्रोसेस, थर्ड प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेटिंग विद फर्स्ट प्रोसेस, फर्स्ट प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेटिंग विद लास्ट प्रोसेस, लास्ट प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेटिंग विद नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस। सो दिस इज नथिंग बट इंटर प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन एंड ऑल प्रोसेस आर सिंक्रोनाइज विद इच अदर। अभी समझ में आया आपको व्हाट इज मीन बाय सिंक्रोनाइजेशन? आर यू गेटिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग राइट नाउ? द पॉइंट इज क्लियर टू एवरीबॉडी? यस, अर्जुन इज सेइंग यस, यस, वेरी गुड। दिस मीन्स नाउ थ्री स्टूडेंट गिव द रिप्लाई, दैट मीन्स दे आर सिंक्रोनाइजिंग विथ मी। अभी रिप्लाई किसने दिया? अभी रिप्लाई दिया अर्जुन ने दिया, गायत्री ने दिया, सिद्धार्थ ने दिया, सोम ने दिया, अभय ने दिया। तो ऑल दिस थिंग्स आर, ऑल दिस स्टूडेंट्स आर नाउ एक्चुअली दे आर सिंक्रोनाइजिंग विथ मी। समझ में आ रहा है ना? अभी अभी समझ में आएगा आपको, सिंक्रोनाइजिंग। ओके अभी भी कोई स्टूडेंट ऐसा होगा कि वो क्या चल रहा है इस गूगल मीट में, वो सिर्फ ओपन करके बैठा है और वो कुछ अलग टास्क और एक्टिविटी भी करता रहेगा। दैट मीन्स ही इज एक्चुअली नॉट सिंक्रोनाइजिंग विथ अस। समझ में आ रहा है ना आपको? तो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम में भी यही होता है, ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम में भी यही होता है। नाउ दीप्ति इज सेइंग यस, दैट मीन्स सी इज सिंक्रोनाइजिंग विथ अस। श्रद्धा इज सेइंग दैट शेयरिंग डेटा विथ ईच अदर, शेयरिंग वो बाद में आएगा, शेयरिंग इज द डिफरेंट एक्टिविटी। शेयरिंग शेयरिंग है तो किसी ने अभी शुरू में क्या कहा था, पैरेलल एग्जीक्यूशन कहा था, सिद्धार्थ ने पैरेलल एग्जीक्यूशन, अर्जुन ने कहा था मेनी टू वन, यहाँ पे चेतन ने कहा था मेनी थिंग्स, ये और श्रद्धा ने कहा है अभी कि शेयरिंग डेटा, ये बाद में आता है, दिस कम्स आफ्टरवर्ड्स। ये शेयरिंग, पैरेलल एग्जीक्यूशन, मल्टीपल एग्जीक्यूशन, वन एट अ टाइम, दिस कम्स आफ्टरवर्ड। तो पहले तो क्या होना चाहिए? पहले तो इंटर प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन होना चाहिए ना, पहले इंटर प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन होना चाहिए, पहले सिंक्रोनाइजेशन होना चाहिए, उसके बाद शेयरिंग होगा। व्हाट एवर यू आर सेविंग सेइंग इज एब्सोल्युटली राइट, व्हाट एवर यू आर सेइंग इज एब्सोल्युटली राइट। शेयरिंग द डेटा विथ ईच अदर, पैरेलल एग्जीक्यूशन, ये सब कुछ होगा। कब होगा? इंटर प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन के बाद होगा, सिंक्रोनाइजेशन के बाद होगा। अगर प्रोसेस एक दूसरे से सिंक्रोनाइज नहीं करते, देन दे विल नॉट शेयर। नाउ अक्षय इज सेइंग दैट कोऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ मल्टीपल, यस कोऑर्डिनेशन इज अ गुड गुड वर्ड यू आर यूजिंग। तो मैं उसके भी आगे जाकर आपको वर्ड बताता हूँ, कोऑपरेशन। सो प्रोसेस आर एक्चुअली कोऑपरेटिंग विद ईच अदर, कोऑपरेटिंग, दे आर कोऑपरेटिंग विद ईच अदर। सो दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, दे आर एक्चुअली कोऑपरेटिंग विदाउट दिस कोऑर्डिनेशन और कोऑपरेशन। कोऑर्डिनेशन इज डिफरेंट ना, कोऑर्डिनेशन मीन्स आई एम अ टीचर एंड 36 स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर, दैट मीन्स आई एम अ कोऑर्डिनेटर नो, आई एम अ कोऑर्डिनेटर एंड यू आर अ मेंबर। सो कोऑर्डिनेटिंग ये भी आएगा, ये बाद में आएगा, कोऑर्डिनेशन विल कम आफ्टरवर्ड्स, बट व्हाट कम्स द फर्स्ट, कोऑपरेशन कम द फर्स्ट, कोऑपरेशन। ओके कोऑपरेशन, सो वन प्रोसेस नीड टू कोऑपरेट विद अदर प्रोसेस। ओके so until and unless it is not cooperating with each other, then it is not possible to share the data, then it is not possible to execute the parallel data, not possible to secure the data. so these things are there and this is very interesting. so वही सब चीजें करने के लिए यहाँ पे जो फर्स्ट ब्लॉक है इंटर प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन, ये किसके मतलब सब सेंटर में आता है, सब सिस्टम में आता है, प्रोसेस कंट्रोल सब सिस्टम, इट इज हैविंग अ इंटर प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन। ओके सो गुड थिंग दैट स्टिल इट इज 4:30, यू पीपल आर अटेंडिंग एंड गिविंग द रिस्पॉन्सेज, दैट इज एक्चुअली द गुड, वेरी गुड साइन। ओके अनफॉर्चुनेटली बिकॉज ऑफ दिस ऑनलाइन एंड ऑफलाइन सेशन दिस एक्चुअली क्रिएट द डिस्टर्बेंस इन आवर टीचिंग एंड लर्निंग प्रोसेस। ओके बट एनी हाउ वी हैव टू फॉलो द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन व्हिच इज गिवन बाय द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ पुणे college administration and government, but actually this is very interesting to learn. okay ये operating system है, बाकी के subject भी है, this is actually very interesting. ये पढ़ने के लिए आपको continuously यहाँ पे college में मतलब you need to be present in the college itself and we should have a day-to-day interaction with each other, then and then you can learn the subject very clearly. but no matter, अभी भी आपके पास समय है, तो आपको क्या करना है कि once the lecture completed, you just refer the books, textbooks, notes, and again the Google is a very good platform where you can search many things about this operating system and administration. So, dear student, now what I will do? I will stop here because now it is 4:24. Still, we are having 6 minutes in our hand, but we will stop and you kindly mark the attendance in that Google sheet. Okay, attendance is very important. That Google Sheet link is available on the WhatsApp group where you Go and mark your attendance. Those who are present, you just create one more column there for today's date. Okay, today's date is 3rd March, and you just mention the P. P stand for present in front of your name. Otherwise, you are absent. You don't do anything. Okay, don't do anything for other students. Okay, you just mark for yourself. So thank you very much for joining. I exit the meeting. Thank you very much. Go and give the attendance.